दिस इज एक्सपेरिमेंट नंबर 11, सिंपल एंड कंपाउंड लीवर एपरेटस. द ऑब्जेक्टिव इज टू वेरीफाई लॉ ऑफ लीवर इन द केस ऑफ सिंपल लीवर एंड कंपाउंड लीवर. नाउ दिस इज अवर सिंपल लीवर बिकॉज इट हैज गॉट ओनली वन हिंज हियर एंड दिस इज अवर कंपाउंड लीवर विच हैज मोर देन वन हिंज. What is lever? Lever is a simple machine. It's a straight or bent rod pivoted in between and is used to obtain the mechanical advantage. Now the fulcrum is placed here in the case of simple lever. This point is known as point B. This is point A. This is point A. This is point B. And at any place where this hanger will be kept, this will be point C. So we need to measure the distance between A and B. This is from this nut to this nut. This will be distance AB, and from this nut to mid of this hanger, the distance will be C. So this is BC. The effort is applied at C and load is lifted at end A. So we'll put effort here and load lifted. This will be our load lifted. So as we apply here at the point C, we can see the readings increasing in this spring balance. So this is how we will verify the law of lever. Taking moments about the fulcrum B, in case of simple lever, we have P into BC equal to W into AB, right? So this will be our P, effort, into length BC, which will be equal to W into length AB. So from here we get W upon P equal to BC upon AB. What is W upon P? Load upon effort. This is nothing but our mechanical advantage. Proceeding over similar lines, we can write the ratio of load to effort in case of compound lever as well. So this is our compound lever. In this end, we will apply effort P and this will be our load W. Again, this length will be our BC. The lengths can be seen here from this diagram. What are the different points here? A, G, F, D, B and C. But what we all need the lengths of BC, GF, BD and AG. So we will calculate all these lengths and we'll put different loads here. Efforts here, and we'll see corresponding load. The formula which comes out for the compound lever is W upon P equal to BC upon BD into GF upon AG. So let's take few readings. In the experiment, what we need to do is we'll find out the readings of the spring balance for a particular weight in the hanger P, and we'll find out the distance BC, WP, and we'll obtain the ratio. And finally, what we'll do? We'll calculate the error in our experimental value as well as analytical value. So W upon will P, that is Q, this point Q will give us experimental value, and ratio will give us our analytical value, and we'll calculate the error between them.
125, 100.
The weight of this hanger is 125 plus 100.
Now 175 plus 100.
175 plus 100. That is 275. This is how we are measuring the distance BC, and this is how we measure the distance AB. Now we'll take. So our first reading is
800 gram.
Somehow about 800 grams.
Second reading, BC distance is
200 plus 175 will be our P, and W here is almost
1 kg.
1 kg. So this is how we will calculate different reading for different distance as well. We can vary this distance for obtaining different readings. Now we'll see the readings for compound lever. This is distance BC, as I told you.
100 gram.
For the first reading of 100 grams, we have a reading here as 200 grams.
Not to anger me, 20.
Second reading.
This distance change.
So this distance can be changed by putting the hanger and various holes. Now the weight is 200 gram.
Midpoint.
Distance BC is changed.
Reading.
600 grams here. Okay. So this was our experimental value, where we saw the readings in the spring balance. For analytical values, you need to do calculations using different length and weight ratios. Okay.